Hi guys, today we are going to look at two concepts. One is Holt winter seasonal method. Why they are waiting in the lobby? I changed that option. Okay, because of different ID. Yeah, one is Holt winter seasonal method, another one is Monte Carlo simulation. These two are only today's topic of discussion I have considered for addressing now. So what is Holt winter is, there are two scientists or the mathematicians or computer science person, whomever may be. These two members, I don't know about their biography detail. So these two eminent personalities invented this model so that they honored with that model, Holt winter's model. That's all. Nothing more to say about what is Holt winter. So this Holt winter model is useful for both additive method and multiplicative method. There are two types of Holt winter seasonal model is available. One is trend, another one is season. Season, within season also long-term seasonal variation, short-term seasonal variation. So what is season? Already we have seen that graph. So for example, trend of my YouTube channel view, trend of my blog view, anything, stock market, the morning it would be different. Then the time, sometimes it will be steadily increasing the stock value. All of a sudden it will go to the fall. Then it will come back, or it will steadily maintained in the same level of index value, or it will be down, rising, then it will go to the deeper down, never it will come up also. These are all seasonal variation. So that sinusoidal wave, like you are assuming, no? Sinusoidal wave is what? No, typical sinusoidal wave is what? No season, no seasonality, no long-term variation, no difference, low, up, down and all. The same sinusoidal wave you are doing like this, that now with Holt winter, no trend, with short seasonal variation, long-term seasonal variation. These are all the four types can be applied with Holt winter model. That's all. So now, I was struggling to understand what is that Holt winter model in the textbook, because that formula was not given. All of a sudden they were given that ATFT, the same smoothing technique, double smoothing, exponential smoothing, double exponential smoothing is the topic discussed in the exactly in the previous class. So what is the formula? It was, there are two components you have seen, AT and FT and alpha component. Alpha is a constant variation. So AT and FT is the two component we used to refer from the data. So that much we are clear. So all of a sudden, if I don't know, maybe the relevant information would have been given in the previous chapter, that I don't know. Directly focused to the point of discussion, I reached the page. So from there, the formula was very missing. So now we are going for the exact formula so that I referred back the internet. So you need to remember this website or any other website, that which one you will follow, I don't know. I'm pasting here. You can refer this Holt winter's model simulation in your Ivan James textbook as well. You need to understand every component of the formula, your equation. That is the reason we have come. There are two types of Holt winter method. One is additive method, another one is multiplicative method. You look at what is additive, what is multiplicative, nothing more. This ST term here, it is combined in the multiplicative factor. We look at here, it is available in the additive factor. So within this additive factor, we need to be in the position to understand what is L, what is B, what is S. There are three constant involved that they are telling that in normal, alpha, beta, gamma constants. In your textbook also, here also. What is that alpha? Equivalently, they are replacing by different terminology. Seasonal component ST, trend component VT, level component LT. That's all. Level, seasonal, trend. So these three are represented by L for level, B for trend, S for seasonal. So these you can put it in any way, alpha, beta, gamma also, choice is yours. So finally, this is the formula, perfect formula I found from the internet. So this formula you need to plug in. Rest all are constant. What else is your input? You can understand the inputs are going to become H, K, M. So these are all the component you may need to plug in from the data. See, look at here, what is M? Quarterly data means M equal to 4 and monthly data means M equal to 12. So or N, in general what we can say N, number of samples or whatever. So that those all are the plugins of this formula. The entire formula, here we are putting it in the multiplicative factor. We are here putting it in the additive factor. So there is only one small difference. So here we are referring this, the formula, both on the additive factor and multiplicative factor. Now, international tourist visitor nights in Australia. So this they want to analyze using Holt Winter method between the year 2016 to 2017. What would be, definitely it would be the month of January, the day one, January 1st, how many tourist visitors have come? Month of January, day two, how many have come? It will be like day wise, or weekly wise, or monthly wise. So that entire data is available. From that data, we may need to understand what is the peak, what is the way the trend had gone in the past, how you can predict. That prediction method, two type you have, or forecasting. Forecasting method, you have two types. One is additive method, one is multiplicative method. You can use both or you can use either one. You can able to predict through this. It is like a linear prediction only. Nothing is very new you are learning here. Only the thing, the formula is going to be changed. The way in which the functionalities are understanding is going to become different. Prediction concept is same. We know the past, we need to predict tomorrow. For example, ice cream sale. So far today, how the ice cream sale was in the season, winter season. I know right from November month, it is too cold in Hyderabad. So I should be in the position to predict the trend of tomorrow also. Human, as a human, we are all predicting. The same we are applying the mathematical model. So here Python code is given. If you look at international visitors nights in Australia, you can get the data. From this figure, you can understand this. If you look at red color, this is Holt Winter method for additive forecast. Blue color, Holt Winter method for multiplicative forecast. More or less, there is a coincidence. Surprisingly, look at the same. Only the thing, little bit peak is more with blue, here more with blue, rest all are of same. This peak count only changes slightly between these two. See, look at here. Here, this is alpha value, beta value, gamma value, RMSE value. So everywhere prediction means RMSE, error value. Error is marginally good or reasonably lesser, I can say 1.7 only there. If it is near zero, you are lucky. But it is 1.7, it is good. So they are having quarterly information of this 2015 2016. Then you are having the T value, the original data we need to find out somewhere. Then you will be calculating YT, LT, BT, ST, then prediction value Y cap. Then from that it is possible to predict for the 2017. If you look at here, 2017, they have predicted using Holt Winter method. The original data guided for this prediction, the original data was 2015 and 16. That's all. Additive states, multiplicative states. So they are separately dividing each and every component, the level component, slope component, season component. If you look at the season here, it is steadily increasing. Whereas here, 2017 to 16, there is no big variation. It is constant, almost season is same. Slope, level. These are all the way you can decompose the components. Now let us go back to the original textbook. Then we come back to the Monte Carlo correlation. I'll be sharing the textbook. I need your acknowledgement once if I shared. Yeah, we reached here. Holt Winter forecasting. See here, if you read this, hope so it is visible for you guys. Now, look at here, Holt and Winter. these two personalities invented this model so that it is cold winter method. It's not a big scenario when it comes technical, but at a gratitude of remembering the contributor, we are touching upon that. Look at here, what is the problem I found when I was following this book is, all of a sudden, see, they are showing additive method, multiplicative method, the prediction model. That they are using Excel minor. All of a sudden, I got stuck up here. AT, BT, I am familiar because of that exponential smoothing model in the last class. All of a sudden, I couldn't able to find out what is ST. Here also, multiplicative factor, this. So that I had gone back, referred the internet. So here, they didn't give any other explanation for STS. Maybe somewhere they would have given, I don't know. Three parameters, alpha, beta, gamma. Then finally, they are coming to the picture. So look at, this is the year, month, unit sale. So the, just you are plotting the trend. So this is what your trend. That are the complete time series data, I can say. The time series data is plotted. Once it is plotted, you need to select appropriate time series based forecasting. For that, what are all the methods available? No trend, trend. What is no trend? What is trend? We look at, my business is going constant. There is no big variation. Today maybe 100 customer, tomorrow maybe 120 customers. Then again like that. It is, there is no like steeping up. For example, 2005, the sale, number of sale was 500. Manufacturing unit, maybe Ford manufacturer, 500 car sold out. 2005, I mean to say. 2006, 700 car. 2007, 800 car. 2009, 1000 car. 2011, 15,000 car. Imagine, it's steadily increasing. That is called trend. No trend means what? Yes, every year Ford is selling more or less 1000 cars only per year. They are manufacturing and they are producing. Car manufacturers doing only 1000. No trend I can see in their business. Constant business. That is what trend and no trend. Hope so you can able to understand what is trend and no trend. Seasonality. Definitely seasonality will be there when it comes to time series. That is what I'm telling. Seasonality, this year or 1 year may, the number of units sold out may be more, next year may be lesser. Because of the lockdown, past 3 to 5 months, car sale was down. Now it may be picking up, I don't know. So that is seasonal. Change in the trend. But no steady increase in the business is happening or not falling down also. That is seasonal. Without seasonality, you can't say time series. Definitely, long-term seasonal effect or short-term seasonal effect, any one seasonality effect will be there when it comes to time series data. That is for sure. So look at here. No seasonality, no trend. You can use either simple exponential smoothing or simple moving average. This is very, very easiest method. Simple moving average. The next is simple exponential smoothing. They are giving forecasting model choices. For this topic only, I have come back to your original textbook. This is important. Next, no seasonality, but there is a trend. Double exponential smoothing. This is more pretty much important concept, I can say, emphasize here. No trend, seasonality. Cold winter, no trend smoothing model or simple multiple regression model. Next, trend and seasonality. If both are available, cold winter additive model or multiplicative model you can choose. This is what choice of model selection in forecasting. There is a topic available in your book. This is the ultimate answer for that topic. That's it. So if you look at here again month, that formula is applied. These all Excel minor. So they have installed, it is free to install it since Excel minor is free for the educators to install and you can experience. But this data we must be in the need. It is not available unless otherwise we purchase this book. It will not be given for free of cost, or you can imitate only, or you can have some other data set. Forecast residual. Then this forecast is plotted with red color line. Actual is plotted in blue color line. more or less it resembles forecast. It is reliable. So there is a what to say? Lesser error, you can say. Error is less. The residual error is less. MSC, they have mentioned. MAD, MAP, mean percentage error. That is what mean absolute percentage error. That is what we discussed, three types of error. This author throughout the book uses three types of error. Regression forecasting with a causal variable. This all we know. It is repeating. This entire book is revolving around trend line and regression forecasting only. So if we look at sale, gasoline sale. So gasoline in the gas industry or oil industry, that gasoline sale. Sales equal to Y equal to MX plus C, we say no. That is what? This what X, this what intercept, this what slope, X variable week. Which week you want to predict if you substitute plug in, then it will give you the answer. 11th week if you want to do, or 11th month you want to do, it will give you the number of gallons. So predict a sales for week number 11. So it will be giving you gallons. So where it is available? Look at gallons sold out, which week. You have the data about 10. The price data, you need to plot. It is a simple linear regression. That's it. The moment you plug into regression equation, it is inevitable. Always you will be getting one slope and one intercept. That slope and intercept you are plugging and forming the equation, whichever you are obtaining through simple linear regression. Then you are plugging in which month you want to find out. For that month, you are trying to find out. That's it. So look at here, this is a slope. This slope you will be finding through regression. So R square is good, reasonably good, 0.63 or 0.68. That's it. So incorporating causal variables in the regression based forecasting. What is causal variable? You can include a separate or all other causal variables. Look at here, price or gallon, week. More than one variable you are incorporating into this. That is what including, we used to call in our conventional machine learning algorithm, multiple linear regression. That's all. That is what they are writing in this way. When I started looking into this title, I was totally collapsed. Then after looking at this scenario and the example, it is called simple multiple linear regression, incorporating all the causal variables. Whenever we want to find out, we will be including causal variables only into the independent variable list. Otherwise, we can call it as the independent variables are called as causal variable. That's all. Nothing more here we need to discuss. Now, I'll go to one of the page number 221, 317. Two concepts we need to understand in order to pick up with Monte Carlo simulation. 221, what you need to understand is the again same story like confidence interval, standard deviation, variance, this all. Before that, we need to understand this one formula, p cap. The statistics p cap is x divided by n, the sample proportion. What is the meaning is, for example, 50 students are there in a class, 7 girls, only 7 girls, rest all 43 are boys. If I want to do analysis only about girls, then this 7 divided by 50 is my p cap. This is called sample proportion. So this sample proportion is used in Monte Carlo relation analysis as per this textbook. Monte Carlo relation analysis, there is no fixed formula. Please understand. Again, it is like the previous topic which I discussed is on, forgotten what is that topic, more or less, linear optimization, non-linear optimization. Yeah, exactly. Linear and non-linear optimization. That equation modeling, optimization equation formation is expertise of your context understanding and mathematical understanding, which I said, same is applicable for Monte Carlo relation also. what domain you are solving the problem, what problem you are solving, why you are doing that analysis, what is the benefit you are going to get. It is a kind of trial simulation. For example, one small analogy I will start with, the Monte Carlo simulation. Just imagine there is a subject, business analytics, let us consider. You have completed mid examination. Imagine I'm conducting every day daily test with the equal portion of topic. The weightage of your test I'm giving equal weightage of topic of preparation. In that continuous 20 days or 10 days, I am conducting a test for you. Imagine day 1, day 2, day 3, etc. 20 days. What is your mark performance? You know, because I am correcting it and I am giving you the performance of everyday test for the continuous 20 days. Let us imagine. Now, what is the simulation here? Can you understand and can you say me? You need to think and tell. Now, what is the thing is, there are a lot of parameters involved in it. You can understand if you are aiming for 100 mark in my next test, there are a lot of parameters can be simulated. What is the main parameters are? For example, number of hours you spent or number of minutes you have spent on everyday test. If you know that, you can do simulation. Perfectly, you can do simulation. For example, day one test I'm conducting for you, you would have spent only 30 minutes of preparation and you would have come and written the exam. You got 40 or 50 or 60. Let us say for consideration. Day two, I have conducted examination. 0 minutes you would have prepared. You would have come and attended the exam. 20 marks you would have got. Day three exam, 1 hour you would have prepared. Then you would have got 80 marks. Day four, etc. Then this relationship, your mark and the number of minutes you have spent and what is the output. You should know this one. The parameter involved in this case or analogy is number of minutes you have spent for the test preparation. So if at all the relationship equation, the moment you find it, immediately I'm going to conduct 30th test. You can able to predict if you spend 0 minutes, what would be your mark? If you spend 10 minutes, what would be your mark? If you would spend 2 hours, what would be your mark? If you would spend 8 hours, what would be your mark? Beyond certain number of hours, nothing will be changed. That signifies the maximum limit of minutes you need to spend in order to get. Then this all called simulation. This is called Monte Carlo simulation. Then you can understand before even coming to the exam, if I study this many minutes, what would be my mark? Then you can able to understand even at the time of writing exam, yes, yesterday I spent only 40 minutes. Then you can able to predict what would be your mark score after the end of the exam. This is one scenario where in which you can apply Monte Carlo simulation. It's a kind of forming the modeling. First, you need to understand your problem, you are understanding your domain, whatever that is your matter, that is pre-processing. You need to form a model. What is model? Input function representing that task, then out of that function you will be getting output. So in that modeling, what is one major criterion you need to understand is there should be the component called random number. Random number should come and sit in your equation or in the modeling. That is called Monte Carlo simulation. That random number function will, you can fix the number from 1 to, see, however you can't spend, see, one everyday test. How much hour you will be having per day? 4 hours only. So 1 to 4, free time you will have maximum 4 hours. 4 o'clock you will be free, till 8 o'clock one guy can study. Before you can entertain and after you can sleep. So the number of hours in your hand is 4. So the random number should be from 1 to 4 discrete. Again, random number can be continuous form, or it can be discrete form. So it need to simulate. So that is called Monte Carlo simulation. We will discuss couple of scenarios for Monte Carlo simulation. In order to do Monte Carlo simulation, as per your textbook, they started with PCAP. What is PCAP? You should understand X divided by N. What is X? Sample distribution. What is sample distribution? Imagine in a class, I want to analyze about girls' attitude or their performance, whatever may be. I am interested only about girl students. So I need to work on only this sample. So number of students in my class are 50. Number of girls students are 7. 7 divided by 50. That's all. This all we know, simple. But mathematically, when I have seen in the formula Monte Carlo simulation, I became afraid. What is this PCAP all about? Then I cross-referred the same textbook. It has come. Now, look at here. This is a formula. They are using most of the time in your Monte Carlo simulation. This is confidence interval, nothing more. 95% confidence interval, 85% confidence interval. This is confidence interval. PCAP plus or minus confidence interval square root of PCAP, 1 minus PCAP divided by N. So this is the formula they are trying to use throughout your, means towards your Monte Carlo simulation. Look at here. One plugin, using the plugin, they are calculating. This formula gives the interval. The decision is what? This is what? Minimum number of hours you should spend for that previous analogy wise, I'm telling you. Maximum number of hours. So using this Monte Carlo simulation, you can find out the minimum worst case scenario, the best case scenario, or any intermediate scenario also, because the random numbers are generated. So it is available into the continuous probability distribution. So whatever the random number you are plugging in, that only your density function. So the density function will resemble based on the random values which you have plugged in. Now after 221, we need to go to 370. In order to understand your textbook context, these are all those stuff you need to be thorough before even. Look at here, especially overbooking model, cash budgeting model, when you touch upon those all, there are few things you should be in the position to understand. Since it is business intelligence, this all required. Look at here, R is the revenue per purchase. So most of the time, business revenue per purchase, F, purchase frequency in number per year, per customer. Say, look at here, imagine Amazon. They may be using this kind of formula. I don't know. I'm guessing. So every customer, their frequency in number per year, gross profit margin, defection rate. What is a defection rate? Is how much of percentage of customers will go away, walk out of your business. So that is defection rate. So these are all few terminologies you should be familiar when you address business intelligence. So look at here, the value of a loyal customer is based on these all formula. Your revenue purchase and purchase frequency in number per year, M. See, look at here, loyal customer. You can hear this word in all the banking sector. Based on my CIBIL score. What is a CIBIL score? Is what is your revenue, income, what are all your loan, is there any default with your accounts? Here which PAN card is attached. Based on your PAN card, based on your income, based on your loan, based on your default, how much you violated in paying back the taxes. Is there any bad remark available on your PAN account? This is what I have got very good CIBIL score. Every time I used to get a call, you are my loyal customer. You are having good CIBIL score. We are ready to offer you credit card. Like this, every month I am getting a call. Almost I reached more than 3 credit card. Never I use emergency purpose only, but these people are compelling me. So already 3. Nowadays I don't even respond to them. Sorry, I have plenty. Keep the phone. So how they arrive to the conclusion, loyal customer? Here is the formula. So based on this formula, they are doing. Similarly, in the banking sector, that would be different. This would be different, that would be different. So this is, you may need to understand what are all the phenomenon involved into identifying the loyal customer in the banking sector. Then you need to arrive such formula. What are all the plugins? What you want to find out? So loyal customer, what you are going to give? So these are all those things. Say for my housing loan, they started asking me, we are ready to give you top up loan 10 lakhs plus. If you want to go for extending, building one more floor or renovating your house, anything, you can go for like that, a call has come. So how they are finding out that loyal customer? That is where Monte Carlo simulation or this business relationship, this all will be helpful. In order to understand the business intelligence, these are all essential. I don't know whether these are all available in your syllabus or not, but it is essential for you to understand. Look at here. This should be in the, any business scenario, profit, revenue, cost, unit price, unit cost, fixed cost. What is profit? Profit is finally the net worth of your appreciation. What is cost? Investment. Always cost is expenditure related, profit is income related. That you should know this all world. Or economics, if you would have studied, you can able to understand. Unit price, per unit manufacturing, how much price? Unit cost, what is a unit price you can fix for per unit? Similarly, in order to manufacture per unit is means, for example, Ford car. One Ford car, what is the price you are fixing? One Ford car, what is the unit cost, manufacturing unit cost? What is the fixed cost? So these are all those components you should be in the position. What is a fixed cost is, see, I am a Ford company proprietor. I need to invest certain infrastructure. I need to invest certain machineries. These are all fixed cost. Nothing can be changed. If I am expanding my unit only, I may go for that is my future problem, my problem. Initially, in order to manufacture a car, I need to hire a place. I need to hire a machinery, yes, those are all fixed cost, salary, taxation, raw material. Raw material today may be different because of corona, all of a sudden everything is changing. Onion value going up, tomato value going down. There are different parameters changing with respect to the situation or scenario or social effect, that I don't know. So that is called variable cost. Everywhere, manufacturing cost or the cost is divided into two components, fixed cost, variable cost, salary. Today, I may be getting cheaper laborer, then well and good. All of a sudden, those people are hired by some other company, they are promoted. Then I may need to pay much more expenditure, I don't know, depending upon the competitor or surplus of engineers, or lack of engineers based on the skill, this all we can't predict. Employee salary is not predictable. Taxation not predictable. Raw material, what is a purchase, not the price or cost of the raw material cannot be predictable. These all are varying cost. Because of this varying nature only, we are going for Monte Carlo relation simulation. So you need to simulate. For example, raw material is not changing. Taxation is becoming huge. Only that parameter you can put random variable. So what is the taxation value? Right now, GST may be for 5% or 2%. Then up to 10% the government loss. How much would be your profit? Then what is the price you need to fix for the car? Today GST may be different. Next 2 years, whatever the car I have manufactured, it needs to be accumulated. It needs to be brought to the market. Then by the time GST, what would be, I don't know. Then I need to fix the car price. All those things need to be taken decision through Monte Carlo relation. Imagine maybe taxation may not be changing. Raw material only changing, or both may be changing. Then both of the variable, I need to apply the random function. I need to simulate for all the values from minimum to maximum. If at all 10% GST comes, If at all 15% GST comes, what is today GST? From that to that, I can apply random function. That all the simulation I can do. Then I can understand what would happen worst, what would happen best in my business scenario, depending upon this varying affecting factors. That is where Monte Carlo relation, I'm making you to understand, because there is no Monte Carlo relation I can teach you form. It is like optimization technique. That is why optimization technique also I didn't teach you form. Only one problem I solved. These are all optimization, Monte Carlo simulation and all. We need to understand the parameters involved in that business case or in that scenario. Monte Carlo simulation you can apply to any, not only business, engineering, manufacturing, economics, finance, what not, even life science, everywhere you can apply. There is no limitation for Monte Carlo simulation. See, look at here, quantity sold, yes. Quantity produced, Q, demand. Like this, given the problem statement, you need to list out all the variables involved in it, components involved in it. See, in any business scenario, whether it is Ford car manufacturing or it is Amazon website, e-commerce, it's after all website. So whatsoever may be, you should be in the position to list out what are all the parameters involved in it. If it is e-commerce website also, there is a fixed cost involved, because I may be purchasing a server, or I may be purchasing the cloud, or I may be hiring one employee for the database management or website administrator, all are fixed cost. Then next, what is varying cost? All those things we need to work out. The parameter may be varying, but more or less same in the business scenario. If it becomes engineering, if it is become manufacturing, if it is become life science, that and all different. Biology also, you can apply this Monte Carlo simulation. So gene mutation, if worst case happens this, what will happen? Best case happens this, what will happen? You can apply the simulation. For example, there is a life threatening factor. This is the scenario happened to my husband himself. There is a wall, mitral wall in your heart. The mitral wall deposited, blocked with scale formation, or it is kind of mineral deposition. So that is not dissolved. It became like a kind of solidification. That wall blood flow is very, very congestion. So that is the first problem, almost life threat problem I have faced in my life. So they will be using Bernoulli theorem. They will be applying, they will be using a lot of mathematical formula. If the blood flow this range to this range happens, this what will happen? If the deposition increases, what will happen? Then what is the number of weeks? Ultimately, when it is diagnosed, immediately they had given 10 days time only for the life guarantee. Within 10 days, surgery need to be undergone, they have declared. So how they are declaring the 10 days? Based on the blood flow, based on the chemical deposition, based on what are all the way the flow of blood will affect other organs. What is the blood supply? It is a required outlet. It is a mitral wall inlet. A mitral wall should flow the blood, throw the blood outside. So what would be that blood flow value? So these are all will be simulated. This is one analogy I'm telling, Monte Carlo simulation for biology application. So they will be predicting if at all the blood flow happens this much minimum or maximum. What is the way? Similarly, days would be one more parameter. So these are all together only. It has been demonstrated through the software. After that only I was convinced, because 7 doctor's opinion I have taken. Lowest doctor to highest costlier doctor I have seen. So initially when I started approaching one doctor, the moment I have seen the costlier doctor, he said that maximum of 10 days. After that, I had come back to the original doctor who is going to do surgery. He said that not even 10 days, I cannot even guarantee for even a day also, he said. So that is the way that software gives the flow, inlet, outlet, days directly shown the software that how that, live video like they have shown that mammography, I don't know what it is. So that kind of video analytics only through that, it has been diagnosed. So there also Monte Carlo simulation. So that random function, they will be assuming this is the flow minimum, this is the flow maximum. If it happens from this minimum to maximum, what would be the outlet? Then what would be the plus, pros and cons? So that everywhere simulation is required, this Monte Carlo simulation, that's all. So if you look at the relationship now, cost equal to fixed cost plus producing K units. Cost per unit. So this is the equation. Similarly, if you want to find out R, then you need to use this price into quantity sold. Revenue, R means revenue, already we have seen. So that I'm telling that revenue. The quantity sold, how much quantity you can sell? One, either you can sell based on the demand or you can sell based on the manufacturing. How much you have manufactured, that only you can sell. So minimum of these two. Number of quantity produced, what is the demand expected? The next is R. So these are all the way you can make the relationship. So now, an influence of diagram for profit. If you want to calculate profit, what are all the parameters involved? Unit price, revenue, direct revenue and profit. This is direct, the way you fix the price of the unit per product, that's all. Another way how you can increase your product is demand, quantity sold. So what is the market demand? How much it is sold out from your manufacturing unit? That directly influences the revenue. The revenue directly related to your profit. The next is what? Fixed cost. Cost is also one of the factor related to profit. See, if you are investing in a large factory, outskirts if you go, what is an acre? It would be in thousands. If you're out of the city, if you invest, what would be the acre, 1 acre cost? After all, that inventory itself. So if you try to optimize there itself, there may be a lot of profit. Next is unit cost. The way how you purchase the raw material, quantity produced, how much you can be able to produce. These are all the parameters directly involved towards profit. So you, what I mean to suggest is, this is the data sheet they are using in Monte Carlo simulation as per your textbook. So this you should understand. That is the reason I have come back and referred this unit. It is good that you need to understand this all. Directly if you look at this data, what you can understand, what you can think, nothing you can think. So look at outsourcing decision model. What is the final concept here is, you are a proprietor. Fine. See, software company, imagine software company. Nowadays people are having lot of liberty. You and me anytime can start startup. So we should have some knowledge. What is the knowledge? How to outsource, where to outsource, how to get the project, how to leverage, how to control the manpower, how to deliver the project. All in and out you should know. No need of coding at all. You may be very poor in coding. You may be very poor in logical thinking. But in and out of the computer science or this software industry related projects, you should have a fair idea. Then you can roll out. So what you can do? Suppose imagine you have the manpower crisis. At your company, all of a sudden IoT related project has come. You are web developer, something imagine. Then what you can do? What related to IoT, streaming data, whatever, that all you can outsource. Why can't you take up that project? Outsourcing. So then the analysis or decision model is, you may hire one employee, you can do related to that project also, or you can outsource also. Which one is feasible? Feasibility study you need to go for. That is what? Outsourcing decision model. Which one will make you more profit? Hiring one or two employee who is expertise into IoT, whether you will be developing that component of the obtained project at your own firm, or you will be outsourcing that and you will be doing. Then you need to analyze the profit and loss of each scenario. There are two scenarios only. That is called decision model. Look at here. Outsourcing decision model. Manufacturing in-house. Fixed cost, $50,000. Unit variable cost. Understand. Unit variable cost. That variable cost only manpower. You may be in need of some few new software in order to deliver that project. We don't know. That all are variable cost purchased from supplier. This is your own company if you sit and manufacture. If you are going for outsourcing from supplier, you are doing unit cost is so much product, that's all. Then the production volume is fixed, 1500 unit you need to manufacture. You need to find out which is the best method, which is the worst method. What is the way you can find out is, look at here, total manufacturing cost. What is that? Fixed cost at your firm means you need to consider your fixed cost. Number of units produced 1500 into 125 plus 50,000. That is what your total manufacturing cost. If you are purchasing 175 into 1500, look at here. This would be your expenditure in both of the direction. What is the difference? Manufacturing minus purchase. Minus 25,000, it is a loss for you. If it is plus, it is a profit. If it is minus, it is a loss. It shows that it is better to manufacture manufacturing at your unit. That is what here it is happening. The same, whatever I am talking here, the same we will be reflecting it into another, 407. Next topic of discussion is 407. These are all foundation required in order to go for, see, look at here. This is what Monte Carlo simulation risk analysis. When the Monte Carlo simulation will come, risk whenever involved, you should be in the position to simulate. You can use this kind of random function, norm function, which all are the kind of functions available in Excel. So they are going either ML minor, Excel minor, or look at here. This is what the sheet I was puzzled. All of a sudden it had come, then referred there. Fixed cost, unit variable cost, unit cost, production volume, manufacturing cost at your premises, total purchased cost. The difference is this. What is the decision is manufacturing. Now, here what you can do is, look at here. I think this is a different scenario. Spreadsheet simulation, data tables. Yeah, look, that formula which we have referred, P cap plus or minus we have referred. That is the formula used here. P cap plus or minus confidence interval Z alpha divided by 2. This is after all a confidence interval, square root of P into 1 minus P divided by N. Here N is the number of data point, that is 20 trials. Confidence interval, you can fix 95% confidence interval. Then P bar value. P bar is 0.55. Then what is 1 minus P bar? 0.45. From that, you are going for confidence interval. That confidence interval is this. Then P bar, one more P bar. What is that? The P bar is 0.22. You will be doing this plus or minus. This is P bar. This square root value is 0.22. You will be doing summation. The interval gives you minimum and maximum value. This formula only I started with. Now we are applying that formula, P cap plus or minus confidence interval, square root of P cap minus 1, 1 minus P cap divided by N. That's it. So this is how you can go for best decision, minimum to maximum, which is available, within which what is extra available is you can go for trial runs. What are all the parameters? You can put it in the trial runs. All those trial runs you can do with Monte Carlo simulation. The cost difference. What are all the trials? First trial, second trial, third trial. With each and every trial, you can vary any one of the component. If you have purchased supplier value or anything, if you keep changing, then you will be noticing the cost difference. Then every trial, for each and every trial, you are going with different confidence interval. Then with a different confidence interval, you are going for cost difference. Every time, Positive is outsource, negative is manufacture. Final conclusion out of these many trials, 20 trials, it suggests that 55% outsourcing, 45% manufacturing. Since it is greater, you can go for outsourcing. So in this trial, it is making you to, or it is suggesting you to go for outsource based on different trials. What are all the trial? You are purchased from supplier, unit cost will vary, variable cost will vary. You are keep on varying either one of these or both of these, depending upon that you are taking the decision. This is Monte Carlo simulation. Look at here. First, you need to find out the probability distribution, uncertain inputs to your model, which are all the uncertain inputs. Identify the output variable that you wish to predict. See the number of trials or repetitions for the simulation. Run the simulation. Interpret the result. This is what typical Monte Carlo relation simulation steps. You can do in Excel or you can do Python or R. There are several packages recent day supports for. Now let us go back to one more topic of discussion on the Monte Carlo with example. Again, I am going back to internet material. These are all sounds to be very good. Look at here. One of the scenario. What is this scenario? Yes, they wanted to find out movements asset price. Something, possible movements of asset price. Some price they want to calculate. Let us imagine like that. Look at here. Days price. It is this scenario, I think so, typically suits for stock market. Previous days price. Periodic daily return. Logarithmic. Who will do this model? This model development need to be done by the expert. Every problem statement, it will vary. Monte Carlo simulation is, ultimately, I can say, you need to identify all the input variable. You need to identify all the affecting parameters, not constraints here. When it is optimization constraints, here all the affecting parameters you need to identify. Then you need to model. Within the model, the affecting parameters are given the random value. You need to identify the randoms or continuous random variable or discrete random variable. Then you need to find, randomize the minimum value to maximum value. Beyond that, you can't do anything. You can't do infinite random number generation and all. So there is a minimum and maximum random trials, number of trials. Based on that, you need to model all the output. That will show you where, what is the maximum, what is the minimum. You need to take decision or interpret. You should be in the position to interpret output of all the trials. That is called Monte Carlo simulation. Risk analysis. It is Monte Carlo is useful for many things. Here it is meant for risk analysis. So next, what they are doing, drift analysis. What is a drift? Is daily average return minus variance divided by 2. This is what drift, that means affecting factor. So after knowing this affecting factor, see, look at here, what is this average daily return produced from Excel, average periodic daily return, then average function is used, variance function is used, like that they have explained here. Look at here, random variable. The moment you say random variable, here they are using standard deviation, then norms in V. So this norms in V is for Excel function. This is useful for random number generation. So the, from the normal distribution, always random number, whenever we are picking, that should be taken from the normal distribution. That will give all the possible scenarios. So normal distribution, if you look at minimum to maximum, extreme minimum, the average all together it is available. So that you need to pick the random number from norms in V. That is called random number simulation. Look at here. E, this is the model. Next day's price equal to today's day's price into e to the power of drift plus random value. This random value will give you the scenario. Anything random will happen. We will be doing random, no? suppose 10 sale happens, what would be my revenue? We'll be sitting and dreaming, no? 5 sale will happen, what would be my revenue? Imagine, when I was working in Bangalore, students used to do lot of earrings through thread earring. They'll be coming and selling to all the students and faculty also. So I used to purchase also. They'll be coming with a dream. If at all, during my lunch break, I'll approach 5 faculty. All the 5 will purchase. What would be my revenue? 50 rupees I will get profit. So that is called Monte Carlo simulation. If at all, none of the faculty will buy today, what will happen? If at all 2 faculty buy today, what would be my revenue? That is called here the random nature. So this will give the possibility of minimum and maximum revenue would happen in the next day price. So this is one scenario of Monte Carlo apart from your textbook. Let us see one more scenario. This is the article latest, I think so. Very latest article, date I don't know. Look at here. Time, fast iteration, volume of experiments. So this is a trade off. All the 3 need to be satisfied. For that, they're claiming that Monte Carlo simulation is better. Now, look at here. Pick a value from the set of possible values from the random variable, accepts. Plug the value into the function that generates the output of the random variable, record the output. These are all the major steps involved in different perspectives I'm telling based on different authors. Look at here, model the process. You need to be in the position to model, define the inputs and outputs, run the experiments, aggregate the result, take the decision. So these are all the steps involved. What is this? Very interesting. This is another way. This is another interesting phenomenon. There are 2 types of continuous input. You will be using probability density function. Discrete input, you will be using discrete probability mass function. That is density here, mass function. So these are all the 2 scenario they have taken. So out of this cumulative, say look at this is a kind of coin tossing or die tossing. So 1000 simulation you are doing. Which is coming more? 3 is coming more. Some inference. Which is coming lesser? 1 is coming lesser. So 1 among all 1000 trial, which is lesser? This is kind of discrete random nature. So for that, these are all 2 simulation. Coming to the story, you can go for 1000 simulation. That is your choice. Let us go for the analogy or story. Simulating work from home insomnia. What is insomnia? The moment you go to sleep time, you may not feel sleepy. I was suffering with this insomnia past 2 years till before May. So the moment I go to sleep mode, whether 9 o'clock also, 1 o'clock also, I can sleep after 1 or 2 o'clock only. Insomnia, that crossing 40 may come, or due to health disorder also may come. The reason I don't know, insomnia. So what is the cause?
Excuse me, ma'am. Even I have insomnia.
Pardon?
Even I have insomnia, ma'am.
Yeah. So that what we are trying to find out from this analogy is, if you go for the first reason they are telling here, if you exceed the number of cups of coffee or tea, that leads to insomnia also. Because the nervous system is hyperactivated. So if you go for injecting the chemicals, caffeine and tin, tea has tin, coffee has caffeine. These are all the chemical you are injecting, that will make more of your nervous to be activated. Then if there are people tea addicted, coffee addicted, they will drink 5 times, 10 times, 8 times also. That all leads to hyperactivation, that nervous. So that insomnia also possible, because you are working all the time, you will consume tea or coffee. Let us imagine. Then that, what makes you to have more coffee? Because you are working from home. That kind of analogy they have brought, fabulous. It's a kind of academic analogy, very fantastic, we can understand. Why you are having more coffee? You are working from home. Next, what makes you to have more coffee? You are wearing, what to say, some kind of new casual wear, that what, pyjama pant. Normally we used to say the track pant. So because of pyjama pant, you are feeling more casual. because you are feeling more casual, you are work from home at your own what to say, couch, that is your own sofa or whatever, that is couch, then you are consuming more coffee, then what are all the parameters here? So these understand this scenario, see how they are simulating, you can able to notice. Fabulously, work from couch. Instead of work from home, they have kept work from couch, that is sitting at sofa, wearing pajamas, so tired, completely fall asleep. These three scenarios only, you will consume your coffee. Either because of casuality at the home, or because of wearing pajama, dress makes a lot. What's the dress you are wearing, depending upon that, your conscious will change. If you consciously observe your mind, you can notice the differences. So tired completely, so you will have cup of coffee. These three scenario only, you will have coffee. Other than that, no other reason. So that whether in this situation, after having coffee, you will go to insomnia or good night sleep, you will have. This is what modeling. Look at here, modeling your work from home, insomnia. I am not able to do any pen. This is very fabulous. This is anyone, even kids can understand Monte Carlo simulation. Now look at, you need to fix. The moment you understand Monte Carlo simulation, it is purely based on probability. That is first caution I'm giving. Second, randomness is involved. Second caution I'm giving. Then modeling is involved. Input and output and interpretation. These are all. Look at here. Probability of working from the coach or home, 70%. Recent days, 70% for not for us. Right from June 3rd, I am working continuously. Maybe occasionally I have taken leave. Probability of wearing pyjama pant, 0.35. Probability of being so tired, quickly fall asleep. Only 5% you will feel sleepy. Because of that, you will be drinking coffee. Now, you need to go for this all probability distribution model. This is a Bernoulli distribution you are taking. Number of working hours in a day. Number of cups that you can drink without getting insomnia. So keep quiet there. You can drink without getting insomnia. So these are all. Then Python code they had given. So with the explanation, very fantastic. Every step they have given articulation. If you look at finally, looking at here, running simulation with all the default values, running insomnia simulations. What you are trying to get? Insomnia, good night sleep, 77% you are getting. Only 33% you are getting affected with insomnia. This is what the inference based on the trials are random nature. Look at here, equal to 1. Couch to be equal to 1 and probability of wearing pyjama pants to 6. So all the time, 100% you will be sitting or working from home, couch. Then probability of wearing pyjama is 60. By that situation, run insomnia simulation for this parameter. Look at here. Now, 57% of the days you are going to have insomnia here in this case. 57% you are having. Only lesser percentage only you will sleep. So mostly you are having insomnia. What is the reason? Because of casuality, you are at home. It is available. You have money. You will purchase pocket full of milk and you will be keep on drinking. That is the reason. At office, there is a constraint. Frequent transition to the cafeteria, people will be noticing, making fun of you or humiliating, or you will be focused, whatsoever may be the reason. So this is what a simple Monte Carlo simulation analogy with science that is given here. See, look at here, runs how many, working hours 8, coffee threshold, peak coach, this all you are 6 coffee per day you are keeping the threshold. You may have 10 also, 100 also. Similarly, Monte Carlo simulation, it is possible to put for smoking. How many cigarette pieces the person is smoking per day? Then the lung capacity is measurable. So you can relate with the lung capacity. If you are dropping, what would happen? The best, if you are increasing the number of cigarettes per day, what would happen? There also you can think of Monte Carlo simulation. It is everywhere it is possible to relate and we can connect. So with that, I'm concluding today. Monte Carlo simulation, Holt winter prediction. So that is for prediction, this is for simulation.